Would you like to learn about the OSI model or the Open Systems Interconnect model and how it pertains to data transfer and networking? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs and I am the founder and CEO of GoCloud Architects and GoCloud Careers. And we're an organization that's really dedicated towards building the most high-performance cloud computing and networking careers. Personally, I've been working in technology now for over 25 years, and I've been helping others get their first tech job or get promoted in tech for more than two decades. And I want to help you get your first cloud architect job, your first cloud engineer job, or any tech job that you desire. Today, we're going to talk about the Open Systems Interconnect model, which is a seven-layer model of data communication. And why is the OSI model or the Open Systems Interconnect model so important? It forms a common language for people to talk about how data is communicated. I like to speak Greek in my house, but I also speak English. But let's say I spoke to you in Greek and you didn't speak Greek, you only spoke English, and we were to try and talk, we would have a problem. So when it comes to precision communications, we have to have what's called the common lexicon, or a common word, or a common language, and that's what the OSI model stands for. The Open Systems Interconnect model is to help you understand and communicate with other professionals. Now, in networking, we're really only working with four layers of this model, but when it comes to end-to-end communication systems, there's actually seven layers. We're going to make it simple what occurs at each layer so you understand this. You may find it on your AWS certifications exams. You'll definitely find it on like a Cisco Certified Network Associate exam. But to really work in technology, you need to understand this, especially when it comes to troubleshooting when things break. So we're going to define seven layers, and we are going to start with the physical layer. The physical layer is the wire, effectively, that connects two organizations. So if you plug in your cable to the back of your computer, that physical cable is the physical connection or your wire, that's the physical layer. Now, realistically speaking, at the physical layer, it could be a fiber optic connection where we're sending light, or it can be a physical, like a wire, where we're sending electrons on the wire, but that's really what's going on at the physical layer. Now, at the physical layer, what we're sending is called bits, and now you know. So layer one is the physical layer. Now let's talk about layer two, or the data link layer. The data link layer is the actual hardware that we're dealing with. You may go to the back of your computer and plug in that Ethernet cable into the Ethernet port. That Ethernet port is the hardware that's associated with it. That is your Ethernet card or your network interface. Now, this is a hardware layer, and if you note on your computer, if you look at its MAC address, there's a hardware address called the MAC address. At layer two, as we're talking about here, we have a hardware address. Now, a MAC address is actually burned into the card, so it is a physical address and it's generally permanent. Now, we can tune it under certain software environments, but at layer two, we're talking about a physical address. Now, at layer two, we're sending something called frames. So let's go back to it. Layer one, wire, and we send bits. Layer two, data link layer, the card layer, and we are sending frames. Next, we get into where the fun is for the network architects like me, the network layer. This is where our logical addresses are. So for example, you put an IP address on your computer, that is a layer three network protocol. So we're dealing with a logical address, one that you can manually assign. And when I started, we were dealing with AppleTalk, IPLS, and all kinds of addresses. But in these days, it's real simple. Network layer addresses are only IP addresses. And what do we send at layer three? Packets. That's why an access control list is often called a packet filter. Now you know, layer one wire, layer two card, layer three the logical address that you assign. Now let's take it up a notch to the transport layer, how we send our data. So we can send our data in multiple ways. If we need reliable communication, we can use something called the transmission control protocol. And here's how that works. I send data to the recipient acknowledges my data, and then I send the recipient more data, they acknowledge the data. Kind of like having a conversation. Did you receive it? Yes. Did you receive it? Yes. Did you receive it? So at the transport layer, we've got multiple protocols, but we're going to be, so we've got, for the most part, TCP or transmission control protocol, like I just described, that's used for reliable transport. We also have UDP, which is used for non-reliable transport, like a voice call or a video call. If you're watching a YouTube video, you're using UDP. If you're on Netflix, you're using UDP. Now, traffic at layer 4 is considered segments. So, layer 1, wire, bits. Layer 2, card, frames. Layer 3, packets, IP address. Layer 4, TCP, UDP, or ICMP, Internet Control Messaging Protocol, that's used for network testing, for example. There are layer 4 protocols, and now you know the first 4 layers, and realistically speaking, this is where networking lives and dies. It's the end of it, all of it. But let's talk about 3 other layers. We, at the 5th layer, have something called the session layer, and this kind of really controls the connection. We're dealing with sockets, for example, in this situation, and what we're sending at this point is data. But, you know, it's part of the system, so we're covering. So layer 1, wire, we send bits. Layer 2, data link, we send frames. Layer 3, IP address, for example, and we send packets. Layer 4, transport layer, TCP, UDP, ICMP, and we send segments. Layer 5 is session, and guess what? We're sending data, because we're above those critical networking things. Now let's get into layer 6, or the presentation layer. The presentation layer presents the data to the applications that you and I use, which we'll talk about next. Now there is one thing in the networking world that does go on here, and this is encryption. So for example, you might have some TLS-based security at this layer, and realistically speaking, that is at layer 6, but we're still sending data. So what do we have? Layer 1, wire, bits. Layer 2, card, data link, MAC address, and we're sending frames. Layer 3, logical address, like an IP address, and we're sending packets. Layer 4, session, controls the connection, and we're sending data. Layer 6, presentation layer, and what are we doing here? We are doing some encryption, and we are presenting data to the application layer. Okay, layer 7, the application layer, what is it? It's the application that you and I use. So, web browser, application layer. Things like HTTP, DNS, SSH, applications that we use are layer 7 at the application layer, and we're sending data. So we'll go through it one more time. Physical layer, wire. We send bits on the wire. Layer 2, data link. This is the hardware part of our situation. At layer 2, we're dealing with MAC addresses, and we are passing frames. Layer 3, the network layer. This is where we have our logical addresses, our IP addresses, and we're passing packets. Layer 4, transport. This is our protocol. TCP, UDP, ICMP, and we are sending segments. Layer 5, the session, which controls the connection, and we are sending data. Layer 6, at the presentation layer, we are doing our encryption and presenting our data to the application layer, and we are sending data. And layer 7 is the fun applications we use, like our web browser. It's our user interface, and at this layer, we are sending data. I hope you've enjoyed this video on the Open Systems Interconnect Model, the OSI model, the 7-layer OSI model, because this will help you when you speak to networking professionals, cloud computing professionals, or you're troubleshooting any kind of communications in the technology world. This is Michael Gibbs, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care, everyone.